you, brother, sister. May I invite you to mention your intentions for this class.
We continue to pray for the good health and the well-being of our numerous health and problems. We pray for the healing of our Father's name and also our Father's name. We pray for the safe travel of our system and staff at the Institute of Spiritual Indonesia in this outing. Enhance the relationship with each other. We will have the strength and the inspiration to continue this ministry.
For the healing of Mary Grace, not only in Franklin's highways, and for the intentions of all those who we have promised to pray.
Today is the obligatory memorial of St. Ezekiel Moreno, Bishop. St. Ezekiel was an Augustinian Recollect known for his simple and open spirit. He was deeply devoted to the Sacred Heart of Jesus. He ministered for many years in foreign lands and strongly defended the rights of the Church. He was born in Alfaro, Logroño, Spain on April 9, 1848. Ezekiel professed his vows as an Augustinian Recollect in 1865, was ordained a priest in Manila in 1871. During the next 50 years, he worked on bringing the gospel of Jesus to the people of the Philippines. Among his many apostolates was his devotion to the Brown Scapular, which he gave to his parishioners wherever he was sent. He was called back to Spain in 1885. In 1894, Ezekiel was named the first Vicar Apostolic of Casanare in Colombia, and then made the Bishop of Pasco, where he remained until 1906. In 1906, a diagnosis of cancer caused him to reluctantly return to Spain for treatment. There he died on August 19, 1906. He was beatified by Pope Paul VI in 1975 and canonized by Pope John Paul II in 1992. In January 2004, the Catholic Bishops' Conference approved the request of the Augustinian Recollects to elevate the observance of St. Ezekiel Moreno as an obligatory memorial throughout the country. And today we also reflect on the gospel passage wherein Jesus challenged a young rich man to give up what he has and to generally share it to those who are in need. We begin our celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Together with the Universal Church, let us pray this office. Each morning, Lord,
you fill us with your kindness.
O Lord, you have been our refuge from one generation to the next. Before the mountains were born, or the earth or the world brought forth, you are God without beginning or end.
You turn men back to dust and say, go back some segment. Your eyes, 1,000 years, are like yesterday, come and gone, no more than washed in the night.
You sweep men away like a dream, like grass which springs up in the morning. In the morning it springs up and flowers. By evening it withers and fades.
So we are destroyed in your anger, struck with terror in your fury. Our guilt lies open before you, our secrets in the light of your face.
Pass away in your anger, Our life is over like a span. Our span is 70 years or 80 for those who are strong.
And most of these are emptiness and pain. They pass swiftly and we are gone. Who understands the power of your anger and fears the strength of your fury?
Make us know the shortness of our life, that we may gain wisdom of heart. Lord, relent, is your anger forever. Show pity to your servants.
In the morning, fill us with your love. We shall exult and rejoice all our days. Give us joy to balance our affliction for the years when we knew misfortune.
Show forth your work to your servants, that your glory shine on their children. Let the favor of the Lord be upon us. Give success to the work of our hands. Give success to the work of our hands.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Each morning, Lord, you fill us with your kindness.
From the farthest bounds of earth,
may God be praised.
Sing to the Lord a new song.
His praise from the end of the earth.
Let the sea and what fills it resound, the coastlands and those who dwell in them. Let the steep and its cities cry out, the villages where Kedar dwells.
Let the inhabitants of Sela exult and shout from the top of the mountains. Let them give glory to the Lord and utter his praise in the coastlands.
The Lord goes forth like a hero. Like a warrior, he stirs up his ardor. He shouts out his battle cry. Against his enemies, he shows his might.
I have put away and kept silence. I have said nothing, holding myself in. But now I cry out as a woman in labor, gasping and panting.
I will lay waste mountains and hills. All their herbage I will dry up. I will turn the rivers into marshes, and the marshes I will dry up.
I will lead the blind on their journey. By paths unknown I will guide them. I will turn darkness into light before them, and make crooked ways straight.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. From the farthest bounds of earth, may God be praised.
You who stand
in his sanctuary, praise the name of the Lord.
Praise the name of the Lord. Praise him, servants of the Lord, who stand in the house of the Lord, in the courts of the house of our God.
Praise the Lord, for the Lord is good. Sing a song of his name, for he is loving. For the Lord has chosen Jacob for himself, and Israel for his own possession.
For I know the Lord is great, that our Lord is high above all gods. The Lord does whatever he wills, in heaven, on earth, in the seas.
He summons clouds from the ends of the earth, makes lightning to loose the rain. From his treasuries he sends forth the wind.
The firstborn of the Egyptians is bold, of man and beast alike. Signs and wonders he worked in the midst of your land of Egypt, against Pharaoh and all his servants.
Nations in their greatness is struck, and kings in their splendor he slew. Sihon, king of the Amorites, all the king of Bashan, and all the kingdoms of Canaan, he let Israel inherit their land, on his people their land he bestowed.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. You who stand in his sanctuary, praise the name of the Lord.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who chose Blessed Ezequiel Moreno to preside as bishop over your holy people, we pray that by his merits, you may bestow on us the grace of your loving kindness through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord came to me, Son of man, by a sudden blow I am taking away from you the delight of your eyes. But do not mourn or weep or shed any tears. Groan in silence, make no lament for the dead. Bind on your turban, put your sandals on your feet. Do not cover your beard, and do not eat the customary bread. That evening my wife died, and the next morning I did as I have been commanded. Then the people asked me, will you not tell us what all these things that you are doing mean for us? I therefore spoke to the people that morning, saying to them, thus the word of the Lord came to me, says to the house of Israel, thus says the Lord God, I will now desecrate my sanctuary, the stronghold of your pride, the delight of your eyes, the desire of your soul. The sons and daughters you left behind shall fall by the sword. Ezekiel shall be a sign for you. All that you did, you shall do when it happens. Thus you shall know that I am the Lord. You shall do as I have done, not covering your beards, nor eating the customary bread. Your turbans shall remain on your heads, your sandals on your feet. You shall not mourn or weep, but you shall rot away because of your sins and groan one to another. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
You have forgotten God who gave you birth.
You have forgotten God who gave you birth.
You were unmindful of the rock that begot you. You forgot the God who gave you birth. When the Lord saw this, he was filled with loathing and his anger toward his sons and daughters.
You have forgotten God who gave you birth.
I will hide my face from them, he said, and see what will then become of them. What a fickle race they are, sons of no loyalty in them.
You have forgotten God who gave you birth.
Since they have provoked me with their no God and angered me with their vain idols, I will provoke them with a no people. And a foolish nation, I will anger them.
You have forgotten God who gave you birth.
Alleluia! Alleluia! Alleluia!
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
A young man approached Jesus and said, Teacher, what good must I do to gain eternal life? He answered him, Why do you ask me about the good? There is only one who is good. If you wish to enter into life, keep the commandments. He asked him, Which ones? And Jesus replied, You shall not kill, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not steal. You shall not bear false witness. Honor your father and your mother, and you shall love your neighbor as yourself. The young man said to him, All of these I have observed. What do I still lack? Jesus said to him, If you wish to be perfect, go sell what you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come follow me. When the young man heard this statement, he went away sad, for he had many possessions. My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
Today we are presented with the story of the rich young man who wanted to follow Jesus but just could not be generous enough to share what he has to those who need them the most, the poor and the needy. This story reminds us that human as we are, we always grow attached with what we have, and this can be a cause for us not to be faithful in obsequio Jesu Christi. We don't become obedient. It becomes hard to become obedient because having what we have and owning what we have is just too tempting to hold on. We forget that what we have is not exactly ours. God has blessed us with what we have so that God could use us to bless others. Are we doing that? This story is a beautiful reminder to us that to truly follow Christ is to be more than just to be charitable to others, but to be truly generous to the point of giving ourselves for the sake of the other. May God help us in this. Christ is the good shepherd who laid down his life for his sheep. Let us praise and thank him as we pray.
Nourish
your people, Lord.
Christ, you decided to show your merciful love through your holy shepherds.
Let your mercy always reach us through them.
Through your vicars, you continue to perform the ministry of shepherds of souls.
Direct us always through our leaders.
Through your Holy Ones, the leaders of your people, you serve as a position of our bodies and our spirits.
Continue to fulfill your ministry of life and holiness in us. You taught your flock through the prudence and love of your saints.
Grant us continual growth in holiness under the direction of our pastors.
All these we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received this wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become for us our spiritual food.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sister, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and the glory of his name, for our good and the good of all in this holy church.
Look with favor, O Lord, we pray, on the offerings we set upon this sacred altar on the feast day of Blessed Ezequiel Moreno, that bestowing on us your pardon, our oblations may give honor to your name through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For us, on the festival of Saint Ezequiel Moreno, you bid your church rejoice. So do you strengthen her by the example of his holy life. Teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we pray.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we hope for you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Ernesto, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her husband, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Ezequiel Moreno, Saint John Eudes, Saint Teresa of Avila, Saint Titus Bratsma, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him. O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so together we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity, in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of our Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace, peace, peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God, our Lord Jesus Christ, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Body and blood of Christ.
Amen.
Page 1386. What you say of me
does not come from yourselves. It is the Spirit of my Father speaking in you.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel.
He has come to his people and set them free. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior, born of the house of his servant David. Through his holy prophets he promised of old that he would save us from our enemies, from the hands of all who hate us. He promised to show mercy to our fathers and to remember his holy covenant. This was the oath he swore to our father Abraham, to set us free from the hands of our enemies, free to worship him without fear, holy and righteous in his sight, all the days of our life. You, my child, shall be called the prophet of the Most High, for you will go before the Lord to prepare his way, to give his people knowledge of salvation by the forgiveness of their sins. In the tender compassion of our God, the dawn from on high shall break upon us, to shine on those who dwell in darkness and the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. What you say of me does not come from yourselves. It is the Spirit of my Father speaking in you.
Let us pray. Renewed by the sacred mysteries, we humbly pray, O Lord, that by following the example of Blessed Ezequiel Moreno, we may strive to profess what he believed and to practice what he taught through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And that's it.
Many greetings from Mindanao, especially from Father Kandeng, who is still under observation. He is confined in Southern Philippines Medical Center, which is a government hospital. But in terms of facility, it is a lot better. So when I saw him, that day, okay and condition na. Pero when he was rushed to the hospital, talagang he was gasping for breath. Hindi pa rin ma-determine bakit hindi siya makatayo. Maybe there is something wrong with his spine. Pero affected na rin yung heart niya. That's why just affected and affected. We are being grateful to the many people who have facilitated that can attend our services and become invited to Japan. Ngayon, pupunta sila at i-visit. Hopefully, hindi pa na siya sa inyong lang. Pero, definitely, it will take more time. Then I went to Busan for the acceptance of our hospital. It's a good group, matured and well educated. So, thank you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass has been offered for peace.
Thanks be to God.
Los carmeni, vitis florigera, senor celi, virgo puerpera, singularis, maternitis, sed Carmelitis, est propitia.